It is time for you to end your greed. It is time for you to treat your employees with the respect and dignity they deserve. It is time to sit down and negotiate a fair contract.
That was Senator Bernie Sanders in Detroit at a UAW rally because they are on strike. That is right. Targeted strikes, very particular strikes in just a few facilities, just three actually. But it's already enough to do the damage. And man, oh man, if they use the full force, automakers and union workers or union workers are going to make their automaker bosses very, very sad. And they're already seeing their stock prices plummet, and that's all they care about anyway, which is probably the problem here. But let's talk about UAW President Sean Fain, who announced that workers at a GM plant in Wentzville, Missouri, a Stellantis plant in Toledo, and a Ford plant in Wayne, Michigan would be going on strike. So workers walked off the job there, picketing outside the plants on Friday morning. It is limited. But again, according to one, I guess the global head of automotive for Global Data, an industry consultant, said that actually they could shut down three quarters of the US assembly plants just by a few of these targeted strikes, just by a few walk-offs. One advantage of a targeted strike for the union is the potential to save resources and extend the possible walkout. Striking union members are eligible for $500 a week from the union's strike fund. So again, trying to a little bit like flex muscle without going full throttle just yet. It is absolutely a tactic, and it's good that there are strike funds. That's why unions exist in part, right? That's why dues exist, so that if there is a strike, that people can still get paid from that union strike fund. So again, there's 145,000 UAW members. If it actually they were all to strike at the same time, we're talking $70 million a week. That's how much it could cost. It would also drain their own funds. So it's touch and go here. I mean, I want to get into specifics about what they're asking for, Senator, but the union also doesn't have the luxury of just striking outright, because it is a lot of money for them to be supporting their own workers. So I'm curious how that will play out politically, or not politically, but sort of with, with these automakers.
I mean, thank God for President Sean Fain and the members who believe in him. One of the things we want to remind our viewers is that when workers go out on strike, they are taking a big risk and they are losing. They are not being paid their full wages or benefits or any of that once they do decide to use the best tool that they have in their toolbox. I mean, that means their backs are totally up against the wall. This is, of course, a last resort. And I think sometimes, especially in the age of social media, Francesca, we can forget, because people are out there trying to be of good spirits, trying to bring good energy. And I just want to remind all of us, myself included, that does not mean that this is a walk in a park and this is the kind of party they wanted to throw. They didn't want to throw this kind of party. They are really putting their family and their livelihoods at risk. And let us not forget, in 2008, at least I'm old enough to remember, we bailed out the damn banks. All right, I hope some people rocking with us today remember that. We bailed out, we meaning the taxpayers, bailed out, excuse me, the auto industry. Hell, we bailed out the banks too, y'all. So that's a whole nother story. Put that one in the parking lot. We bailed out the auto industry. They begged us to bail them out. But yet and still, they are making record profits, having stock buybacks, Franny, as you laid out, but yet unwilling to share that wealth with the people who helped them make it. Like, there's something immoral about this. And definitely, to quote Andrew Yang, the math ain't math. And that's one of my favorite quotes from Andrew Yang. The math is not math in here. So I'm so glad that President Fain is saying, we want a 40-something percent pay increase.
Yes.
We want, CEOs make 399 times the wealth of the average worker. And for what? These companies wouldn't be where they are. The big three wouldn't be where they are right now today without those workers. And then, friend, the point that you made about their strike fund, that strike fund has about $785 million in it. But as you laid it out, if they had to pay, you know, subsidized because they can't even pay full salaries for all of their workers. That strike fund, while $785 million is a lot of money, once you start having to use it for over 145,000 workers, it goes very, very quickly.
Yeah, I mean, we'll see, you know, like, let's get into actually what they're asking for. Like you mentioned, that 40%. And I don't think this is the same as, you know, SAG and WGA, right? I hope automakers have a lot more sense than the AMPTP. But let's look at it, you know, because it is worth holding out for when it comes to these workers. What are they asking? They want that 40% wage hike over 4 years, amounting to 46% compounded, along with the cost of living increases, beefed up retirement benefits, including pensions on par with what auto workers previously received, and full pay for a shortened 32-hour work week down from 40. I love that. Nina snapping in the background, so we're on board. All three companies say that they're now offering, so already 20% raise during the life of the contract with a 10% raise at the start. The union started with the demand for an immediate 20% and four additional raises of 5% each year over the course of a 4-year deal. So they're trying to come a little bit to the table, but mind you, they're very late on this, okay? The demands they received weeks and weeks ago, I think about 6 weeks ago, is when the automakers received these demands. So now they're meeting them, and they're literally only meeting them just half of what they're demanding. So, which sounds halfway, but let's talk about how much money these companies have been making. So you know that because they're paying their executives crazy money. UAW has pointed to three big executives' pay in demanding higher pay for its workers. For example, GM chief Mary Barra's compensation grew by 32.5% from 2018 to 2022, prime pandemic. She gets over 30% wage increase, salary increase. During the same period, the median GM employee's pay grew by 2.8%. Public filings show. So there you go. This is absolutely absurd. And again, the pandemic is being blamed in terms of, oh, workers don't want to work anymore. No. Workers understand the value of their work more so than ever. I mean, then UAW, obviously, this is already a unionized workforce. So now they're flexing. They know they can flex and they want to flex. And they know that it's going to enact some costs on these automakers. So GM and Ford stand to lose $2.5 billion and $3 billion in revenue, respectively, for each week a widespread strike lasts. Goldman Sachs Equity Research previously estimated, of course, that's again, they're the ones in control of the, you know, all the stocks. They're worried about the stock money and the stock price. By comparison, agreeing to a 40% wage bump for UAW members would cost General Motors $4 billion to $5 billion and for Ford $5 billion to $6 billion over 4 years. So weekly, each week losing $2.5 billion, $3 billion, or 4 years, doling out $5 billion, doling out $6 billion.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.